Hey guys, it's me, Max Rainbow, and I am back for another video. So today I am super duper excited to be continuing on my reactions to Eurovision 2022. In this video, I'm gonna be reacting to Germany's entry called Rockstars by Malik Harris. I am super duper excited to get into this reaction. Number one, I feel like I'm giving a little rock star. Like, you know, I got kind of my shag hair on that I absolutely hate this wig. Like, you probably will notice if you watch any of my other reactions in this wig, I keep messing with it. I just feel like it doesn't look good, but the show must go on. But, you know, I feel like I'm giving kind of like messy rock star vibe meets like Chanel from Spain, you know, with the bodysuit. But I'm excited to get into this reaction. No, I'm not. Because I actually did follow Germany's national selection. However, I didn't listen to this song. I don't know if it wasn't on Spotify when I listened, because I only listened to the ones that were on Spotify. I didn't listen to this song, but I did really, really love Anxiety, and I loved I Swear to God. Those songs were so, so good. So when neither of them ended up winning, I was kind of disappointed. However, when I watched like Anxiety's performance, like, girl, I could tell you got anxiety from that. However, it seemed like the fandom was pretty happy about the results from Germany's national selection. So I'm excited to see what the hype was all about. So without further ado, let's get right into reacting. Also, to be quite honest, Germany's at this point where there's only up for them, for me. Like, last year was bottom of the barrel, in my opinion. So it'll be hard for you to not impress me based on what we were compared to last year. I am going to react to the national final performance because you guys tend to prefer to see those. Oh, very immediate start. Oh. Ooh, I like his voice. It's really like nice and raw. Hard. Like, it feels very youthful. It feels very, like, I don't know. Raw. Ooh. Hey. Okay, he's playing all the instruments. Boom. Okay, so the staging's a little bit like all over the place, like all these different instruments and everything. It's kind of a lot, like, you know, but look where we are. Okay, so it's just like a reminisce about, you know, your childhood, looking back and reflecting on where you've come in life. You know, a nice little inspirational moment. Okay, a little spoken word. Come on, slam poetry, bring it home. I don't. I actually, well, I mean, I'd love to be some like rich, famous person. That'd be great. But I like who I am. It's taken a while for me to get there, but I wish I'd still not give a damn about how I come across. I wish the way I saw myself had never got lost in all the worries, all the thoughts, all the thinking, all the parts. Okay. Yeah, I love his energy. I love the way that, can we press pause or do a restart and be who we are? Okay, yeah. It's taken me somewhere. I love the kind of chaoticness that he brought to that. You know, the passion. I wonder who that is. He knew all the words. Unlike that girl that sang Soap. No, that must be his dad or something. He's wearing a shirt with his face on it. Stand with Ukraine. Purr. That was fine. That was perfectly fine. I do feel like Germany had better songs. That one just was a little bit like, again, generic, inspirational. It had a little bit of uniqueness with the spoken word, like, rap part. But other than that, I mean, the actual chorus and the majority of the song was kind of generic. Just kind of like, feel good, like, inspirational, look at where we are now. Like, you know, very lovely. But I feel like Ukraine had better songs. Like, I know that Miss Anxiety Queen, I know that she kind of flopped with her staging. Like, I'm not gonna lie. She kind of flopped with the stage presence and everything, but swear to God, they should have won at least. Like, they had stage presence. They were good. Like, I mean, not that he didn't have stage presence. He was charismatic. He was very cool. But this one doesn't leave much of an impression on me, honestly. It doesn't make me really interested to go back and re-listen to it. Like, I don't know. Something about it, it just doesn't really connect with me. And I don't know if I just don't connect with the storyline. Maybe I don't understand what the storyline is. But it doesn't really connect with my soul. You know, okay, maybe I'm not really understanding this song because I just went through all the a bunch of the comments on the performance and everybody's like, this is gonna win Eurovision. Am I crazy? Am I being gaslit right now? I don't see it. Like, this is giving me like Germany bottom of the scoreboard, frankly. But maybe I'm wrong, but it's just the staging seemed chaotic. It didn't connect with me. I didn't get the depth of the lyrics. Let me actually look up the rap part because I didn't quite like get everything he was saying because it was so fast. So let me find that out. He says, sometimes I got this kind of sting that's right inside my chest. Its only purpose is convincing me that I'm a mess. And even though it's always been an uninvited guest, it finds a way in nonetheless. Wish I could change my address. Okay, too much rhyming. We rhymed 5 lines. That's a little bit too much rhyming for me. Like, it's a little bit much. I wish that I could just go back and be the way I was. I wish I'd still not give a damn about how I come across. I wish the way I saw myself had never gotten lost in all the worries, all the thoughts, overthinking all the parts, so exhausted, always caught up inside my thoughts, doubts, and flaws, and I'ma count them all. Somebody catch me, I'm about to fall. Yeah, I'm about to fall. Okay, so yeah, I mean, that's what I got from the song. It's just about like, it's about like wishing you could go back to those times where you were more carefree, where you didn't care, you know, where we didn't have all these problems, like adulthood, like we got, you know, taxes, you know, stuff like that. I don't know, it's not that deep of a message. Like, it's kind of a trope. It's kind of like, you know, a message everybody's told once before in a song. It's not like that deep of a message. I don't know. Unless, I mean, I don't know, maybe there's a personal story behind it that I don't know about, but, you know, I'm watching from the perspective of a person who's probably like the average viewer who's gonna watch Eurovision. If he does have a story that connects with, they're not gonna know. And it's kind of just like a whatever for me, I think. But hey, it looks like I'm wrong based on the comments under that video. So yeah, guys, that is it for my reaction to Germany's entry for Eurovision 2022. Don't forget to leave in the comments down below what you think about their entry this year. As usual, if you like this video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel so you don't miss out on any other video that I do. As well as don't forget to follow me on my Instagram and my Twitter, @MaxyRainbow, so you don't miss out on any posts, polls, live streams, anything like that. And yeah, guys, my name is Maxy Rainbow. I will see you all later. Goodbye. Mwah.